So good morning to all. Welcome to class 11th economics class. From today onwards, we are actually starting our course material. I have already explained to you about the curriculum, that what all chapters, what all units we need to study in class 11th, microeconomics as well as in statistics for economics. Today we are starting with microeconomics first. Where unit number 2, which I introduced you in the previous class, unit number 2, that is theory of demand and consumers' behavior, we are starting that unit. The chapter which we are starting today from that unit is theory of demand. So kindly note down the name of the chapter in your notebook or on loose sheets, whatever you are having. The chapter name is Theory of Demand. Theory of Demand. And this chapter, Theory of Demand, is basically about the demand, that what kind of demand do we face in our economy by the consumers, and how it is related to price of a commodity, and how it is related to price of a commodity. So we have to just study, we have to start today, theory of demand. All right. I'm sharing screen with you people. There is a PDF based on this chapter, as you people are not having the books right now. So I have made a PDF of this chapter, and I will be sharing this PDF today right after the class in your WhatsApp group as well, so that you can study at your home as well. All right. So I think it is visible to everybody. Just please do write in the chat box. It is visible to everybody. You all can see this. Kindly write down in the chat box whether it is visible to all. Okay, it is visible to all. Okay, fine, good. So you all can see that this is the chapter Theory of Demand from unit number 3. From unit number 2, chapter is Theory of Demand that we are starting today. Okay. So let's start the chapter. Start karte hain chapter ko. I told you the meaning of demand in the previous class. Please, one more thing, if you face any problem, do write in this chat box only. If you will be writing in the WhatsApp group, I am not able to see the WhatsApp group during the class. So whatever problem if you face during the class, just mention, just write down in the chat box only, because I would be watching out chat box on regular basis on my screen, but I would not be able to see the WhatsApp group at this time. So kindly mention your problems, your doubts, anything on the chat box, not on the WhatsApp group, please. The voice is not clear. I hope I'm clear now to everybody. I hope now the voice is clear. Maybe due to some internet problem at your end or maybe at my end, the voice may break, but I would try. Okay, so let's start the chapter demand. I told you the meaning of demand, that what is actually meant by demand. The demand ka kya meaning hai? In the previous class, I told you about the meaning of demand, that what is actually demand. Now I'm pointing out some points on screen. I hope you will be able to see that. See. Let us understand the three different terms first. Firstly, we are going to understand three different terms. पहले हम लोग जरा तीन terms की बात कर रहे हैं different. Now, what are these three different terms? First, desire. What is meant by desire? If I talk about desire, so desire is something that is just wish. Like a desire to have an Audi car, or a desire to have Mercedes, desire to have my own school. So this is my desire, something which I wish for. So if in one mark the question arises, what is meant by desire? So you can simply say desire means a mere wish to have a commodity. It's simply a wish that you want to. You wish to have the particular thing. I wish to have an iPhone. I desire to have an Audi car. It is known as desire. Now, what is meant by want? So, what do we define that what is want? So, if I say if the poor person wins a lottery, and now he has enough money to buy a car, then his desire for a car will now be termed as want. Right? Which means, if the desire of a poor person for a car just rupees 200 in his pocket, it is a desire. If a poor person is having rupees 200 in his pocket, and he want to or he desire to have a car, that is known as a desire. But when we talk about want, so I will say, want is that desire which is backed by the ability. And willingness to satisfy. Want is that desire which is backed by the ability and willingness to satisfy. For example, now that poor person is having lottery amount because he has won lottery. So now he is having lottery amount in his pocket, and he want to have a car now. That becomes a want. But what will actually demand means? We have to study. What will actually demand means. So when we define demand, that what is actually demand, we will simply say demand is the quantity of that commodity which a consumer is willing to buy at a particular point of time and at a particular price. Now please listen very carefully. Where we say that demand is the quantity of a commodity that a consumer is willing and able to buy at each possible price. That means demand is simply defined as the quantity of a commodity that a consumer is willing to buy. That is known as demand. मैंने आप last class में भी demand का meaning already बताया था कि demand मतलब होता है एक ऐसी commodity जो consumer buy करना चाह रहा है. Where a consumer want to buy. A commodity which a consumer is willing to buy at a particular price, एक किसी भी particular price पे जब वो buy करना चाह रहा है, at a given period of time. Now let me again tell you one thing. How would you think that demand is related to price? Suppose when price of a commodity, any commodity, when price of a commodity is rupees 20. And I am buying 4 units of that commodity at that time, right? And when the price of a commodity is rupees 30, when the price of commodity is rupees 30, definitely I would be now buying less units of that commodity, right or not? I would be buying less units of that commodity, which means I will simply say that price and demand have inverse relationship. Price and demand have inverse relationship. When price rises, demand falls. And when price falls, the demand rises. So they have inverse relationship. A commodity ka price jab kam hota hai, we try to buy more of that commodity. And when the price of commodity is more or high, we try to buy less of that commodity. So somewhere I would definitely say that the price and demand have inverse relationship. They both have inverse relationship. If price rises, the demand falls. If price falls, the demand rises. So kindly write down this point, which is very, very important. The price of a commodity and demand have inverse relationship. If price rises, demand falls. If price falls, demand rises. All right. Is it clear to everybody till now? Kindly show me a thumb, please, if it is clear to all that what is meant by demand and how it is related to price. Okay, Darshika, Gulzara, Paridhi, Sadika, Van Shukla, Dhruv Gupta, Kanishka, Rakesh, Himanshu Razdan, Vinod, Kushi Arya, Soumya, everybody. Okay, so let's move further. First question was, you can write the questions also side by side. Question number one is, what do you mean by demand of a commodity? Kindly write down. What do you mean by demand of a commodity? And how it is related to price? And how it is related to price? I repeat the question. What do you mean by demand of a commodity? And how it is related to price? And how it is related to price. The three terms which we have studied, first was desire, second was want, and third is self-demand. Desire, want, and demand. So can I say that if I desire to buy something, then if ability is added to that desire, if ability is added, willingness to buy. Agar meri desire hai, I want to buy a Mercedes, but I am not willing to buy that. Why I am not willing to buy that? Because I am not having money to buy that. Then it cannot be my demand. So price is very important. Willingness to buy is very important. That I desire to have an Audi car. I desire to have my own bungalow. I desire to have my own school. Desire to be all people do, but if willingness to buy is not there, then that cannot be demand. That cannot be demand. So ultimately, I would simply say that willingness to buy should also be there along with your desire. Then only it will create a demand. Okay. So let's move further. You can see on your screen determinants of demand, right? Determinants of demands. Kindly write down the second question. Kindly write down the second question. Question number two. Question number two is, what are the determinants? What are the determinants of demand? Question number two is, what are the determinants of demand? What are the determinants of demand? This is our question number two. What are the determinants of demand. See, question ko please write down in or form also. In another form, how this question can come in exam. The question, kisi ka or form likhe question ka. The or form of this question is, what are the factors? What are the factors that can affect demand of a commodity? What are the factors that can affect the demand of a commodity? Now, what are the factors that can affect the demand of a commodity? So, very first factor that will affect the demand of commodity. Very first factor that will affect the demand of commodity. Answer would be very first point. Its own price, as you can see. Of course, its own price of the commodity. यही तो सबसे पहला ओन प्राइस होगा जो अफेक्ट करेगा प्राइस को जो अफेक्ट करेगा डिमांड को ऑफ कोर्स इट्स ओन प्राइस ऑफ द कमोडिटी बट हाउ इट्स ओन प्राइस विल अफेक्ट द कमोडिटी ऑफ कोर्स इफ प्राइस ऑफ द कमोडिटी इज मोर सपोज इफ आई हैव अ पेन एंड प्राइस ऑफ पेन इज हाई आई विल बी बाइंग लेस पेन लेस नंबर ऑफ पेन इफ प्राइस ऑफ द पेन इज लो आई विल बी बाइंग मोर नंबर ऑफ पेन So ultimately the price of commodity inversely affects its demand. किसी भी commodity को सबसे पहले जो affect करेगा that will be its own price. उससे खुद का price उसको affect करेगा. How it will affect? Inversely. Price will be more, demand will be less. If price will be less, its quantity demanded will be more. So ultimately its own price affects the demand of commodity. Very firstly. Own price will affect the demand of the commodity. Now I am unmuting Siddhi, and she will explain me how price of its own commodity affects the demand of that commodity. Siddhi, I have unmuted you. Kindly speak. Are you listening, Siddhi? साधिका गुप्ता आई थिंक सम इंटरनेट प्रॉब्लम इज देयर और व्हाट आई एम नॉट एबल टू अनम्यूट परिधि ओके परिधि Tell me how its own price of a commodity will affects its demand. With an example.
It will inversely affect.
Okay, it will inversely As affect the demand.
As the price will go high, demand. Yeah, if the price is high, there will be less demand, and price is less, there will be high demand.
Okay. So it will inversely affect demand. If I simply say the price is more, then demand will be less. If I say price is less, demand will be more. Okay. So ultimately, price of commodity is inversely affected with its demand. All right. Can you give me an example, or I'll take example from some other student. All right. I'll take example from some other student. Let's go to Kanishka. Kanishka. Just explain this point that how a price of commodity affects its demand by taking some example. Kanishka, over to you.
Your voice is not clear.
Now it's clear. Neelima Jain.
Yes, sir.
So how a own price of commodity is going to affect its demand?
Sir, as demand is inversely proportional to price, when the price is increased, there will be less demand. For example, if anything which is 30 rupees, and if the price is increased by 50, then there will be demand of that.
Okay, fine, good. So let's go to Darshika Jain.
Hello.
Darshika Jain.
Yes, sir.
An example, try to define that how its own price of a commodity is going to affect its demand.
Sir, as price is inversely proportional to demand, and if the price increases, the demand, our demand will also, as price increase, our demand decreases. For example, as the price of a car is increased, so our demand decrease.
Okay.
Hello?
Yes, listening. Fine. Can you tell me any situation where even if the price increases, still there will not be any, you know, demand will not decrease? Any situation where if you find even if the price is increasing, the demand will not fall. The demand will not fall. And very good answer is given by Namish Jalan in the chat box. He said sanitizers during this lockdown period, during this COVID-19 period. Very good example. Because it has become a basic necessity. Abhi necessity ban gayi hai COVID-19 se bachne ke liye sanitizers. Even if the price of sanitizers has increased, we are still buying sanitizers. Why? Because that is a necessity this time. Any other example? That was a special case, COVID-19. Any other example where even if the price is increasing, the demand will not fall? Very good example by Ambika. Eat and rice. Okay. Salt by the Chirag. Okay. Very good. So I will simply say basic necessities which are essential for life, demand will not fall even if the price rises. Correct or not? Agar suppose us basic necessity ka price gir bhi jata, we will still buy that. Why we will still buy that? There is no other option. I want to consume that. Is the basic necessity, and because it is a basic necessity, definitely I need to purchase that product even if the price of that product is more. Okay, any other example? Ye to hua ek one example, basic necessity, where there is no inverse relation between price and demand, right? Even if the price rises, the demand doesn't fall. Ek point hua basic necessity. Can you tell me any other point where still even if there is rise in price, the demand will not fall? Any other condition where even if the price is rising, the demand will not fall? Any other point or any other condition? I'm waiting for your answers in the chat box. Where even if rise in price, demand doesn't fall. But we are not considering basic necessities this time. Okay. What about habitual necessities? Tell me, what about the habitual necessities? Habitual necessities or the products which are in the habit of the consumer. Okay, one first thing was basic necessities, which are the essentials of everyone's life. Food, water, right? Wheat, rice, sugar, where we need to buy that, even at high price. What about habitual necessities? If any product is in the habit of the consumer, so there are many products which are in the habit of the consumer. You can take the example of cigarettes. Are in the habit of many consumers. Take the example of liquor, which are in the habit of many consumers. Even though you can take the example of cold drink, which are in the habit of many, you know, youngsters. Many people have a habit to drink cold drink. Right. So even if the price of cold drink rises, or even if there is rise or hike in the price of cigarettes or liquor, one who has a habit of consuming that commodity will definitely consume that commodity even at high price. Yes or no? Agreed or not? Show me your thumb if you're agreed with this point. The habitual necessities will definitely not impact demands. Very good. So definitely I will say that whenever there is basic necessity or whenever there is habitual necessity, the demand of a product is not, the demand of a product is not all affected. Even if at high price we are going to buy that product, we will buy that product even at high prices. All right. So we were studying the factors affecting demand of the commodity, where I told you the first point that price of given commodity. Firstly, demand is affected by the price of given commodity, right? And secondly, I will take the example of, please write down the second point which will affect the demand of commodity, is taste and preferences of the consumers. Please write down. Taste and preferences of the consumers. So very first point which affect the demand of commodity is its own price. If its own price will rise, the demand will fall. If its own price will fall, demand will rise. There is inverse relationship between price and demand. We have done first point. Now the second point is taste and preferences of commodity. Now, taste and preferences of commodity, how it will affect the demand. See, if you like the taste of a commodity, you will definitely buy that commodity. If you don't like the taste of the commodity, definitely you will not prefer to buy that commodity and demand will decrease. Agreed or not? If you like the taste of the commodity, you will prefer to buy that commodity, demand will increase. If you do not like the taste of a commodity, that means you don't prefer to buy that commodity, demand will fall. So ultimately, there is direct relation. There is positive or direct relation between taste of a commodity and its demand. I hope this is also clear. Pehle zamane mein, you must have seen bell bottom trousers. You must have seen, hai na? Pehle zamane mein bhi piche 2-3 days before Shole movie was coming on TV. So Shole mein Amitabh Bachchan and other actors are just wearing bell bottom trousers. Wo niche se bade bade khule khule trousers. Would you like to wear the bell bottom trousers? Is this aap pehnoge bell bottom trouser? Definitely not. Sabse pehle Sameer Goyal ka reply hai, sir, no. Kaise pehen lenge hum bell bottom trouser? Because you don't prefer to buy that commodity. Why? Because it's not in the trend. You don't like this. Definitely, if you prefer to buy a commodity, if you like the taste of commodity, you prefer to buy the commodity, you will definitely, demand will increase. You will buy that commodity. Right? And if you don't like the taste of a commodity, you will not prefer to buy that commodity and hence its demand will decrease. I hope this is clear to all. So we have studied 2 points till now. Question which we are doing is, what are the factors that affect the demand of commodity? Right? We are doing, what are the factors that affect the demand of a commodity? So the first fact which we have studied is its own price. Sabse pehle to demand affect karega its own price. Its own price of the commodity is going to affect the demand of commodity. In inverse way, in a negative way, that if price rises, demand falls. If price falls, demand rises. And secondly, second factor which is going to affect the demand of commodity is, I told you, taste and preferences. Just mean what you are going to write in the explanation, that if a consumer likes the taste of the commodity, he will prefer to buy that commodity. The demand will rise. And if the consumer doesn't like the taste of the commodity, doesn't prefer to, you know, buy that commodity, the demand will fall. Ultimately, direct relation in taste of a commodity and its demand, and inverse relation in price of a commodity and its demand. I hope this is clear to everybody. Okay, so the question, what are the different factors that can be affected by demand, that affect the demand, and first point, its own price. Bulzara is going to explain me own price and how does it affect the demand of commodity. Over to you, Bulzara.
So price of a commodity is the first factor that affects the demand of commodity, and if the price is high, then the demand will be less, and if the price is low, then the demand will be high. But in some cases, this is actually not applicable. Cause
we'll study that cases in next class. Just go move for the second question, second point of this question: taste and preferences.
So taste and preferences of a consumers matter the most. That if you like the product, the demand will increase, and if you don't like the product, the demand will get less, and hence effect.
Yatin Arora, second, taste and preferences. I want to know from you. Over to you, Yatin. Explain how does taste and preferences will affect the demand of commodity. Bolye. Yatin, you can speak. Start speaking, we can hear you.
Sir, it depends on the fashion. If a thing is...
If you like the taste of commodity, we'll simply say if you like the taste of commodity, definitely we will buy that commodity. If we don't like the taste of commodity, we will not buy that commodity. All right. So 2 points of this question we have covered till now, and we'll be completing this question in the next class tomorrow. And most probably from tomorrow, I will be taking class on the new app, which I have sent a message in WhatsApp group also. Right. Next learning. I hope you all have just downloaded the application. Tomorrow, most probably, I will be taking class on the new app only. So those who have not downloaded, kindly download the app today. So meet you all tomorrow.